In match problem 8, we again have a rational function. In this case, x squared plus 4x plus 3 divided by x plus 3. So we have the quotient of two polynomials, which means we have a rational function. So we could start this off by trying to use direct substitution. If we were to do that, we would get negative 3 squared plus 4 times negative 3 plus 3 over negative 3 plus 3. So this would give us 9 minus 12 plus 3 over 0 is going to be equal to 0 over 0. Now, that's not a real answer. In fact, we refer to this as an indeterminate form. I'm running out of space there. Indeterminate. It's a little bit different than simply dividing by zero, where our function would be undefined. But for right now, it's enough to understand the same idea here. Our function breaks. So we can't use direct substitution in this case because we're getting that zero in the denominator. So what we need is another approach for this problem. So what we're going to do is rewrite it a little bit. We're going to keep the limit the same. We're going to keep the denominator the same. But the numerator in this case could be factored as x plus 3 times x plus 1. So these are identical functions at this point. All we've done is factor the numerator. And now we have equivalent terms or equivalent factors in the numerator and denominator. So x plus 3 over x plus 3 will cancel out, leaving us with x, the limit as x approaches negative 3 of x plus 1. So now we have a polynomial function, and we can evaluate this limit using direct substitution. And in this case, that limit is going to be negative 2. So if you encounter a rational function, the first approach is to try direct substitution. If that gives you a 0 in the denominator, we have to try something different. The new approach we're introducing now is to look at the numerator, denominator, see what can be factored, and then try to cancel out some terms, or cancel out some factors. That should leave us with then something that we can evaluate through direct substitution. In part B, we have a similar case. If we tried to plug in x equals 4 in the denominator here, we would get a 0. So direct substitution can't work here. But we also have something a little bit tricky going on in the fact that we have these absolute value bars. So the numerator can be factored. We could rewrite this as the limit as x approaches 4 of x minus 4 over x plus 4, since what we have is the difference of squares, x squared minus 16. So x minus 4 over x plus 4 times the absolute value of x minus 4. Now here, x minus 4 and the absolute value of x minus 4 can't cancel out with each other because these aren't equivalent expressions, because of those absolute value bars. So what we're going to do is take advantage of an idea here that relates to absolute values. If we're dealing with values of x that are greater than 4, then x minus 4 over the absolute value of x minus 4 is the same thing as x minus 4 over x minus 4. The reason is we're taking values that are bigger than 4. So if we plug in 5, 10, 1,000, whatever we plug in for x, if it's bigger than 4, these absolute value bars are essentially meaningless because we already have a positive value. So we could just drop those. X minus 4 over x minus 4 is just going to equal 1. If x is some value less than 4, then x minus 4 over the absolute value of x minus 4 is going to equal x minus 4 over the opposite of whatever x minus 4 is. So again, what we're doing is plugging in something smaller than 4. So we're going to take something smaller than 4, like 0. 0 minus 4 would give us negative 4. But the absolute value bars basically say make that positive. So whatever answer we get for x minus 4 we're just going to flip the sign. We're going to make that the opposite. So in this case, x minus 4 over x minus 4, those still cancel out, leaving us with 1 over negative 1, or just negative 1. So using this idea, we're going to break this limit problem into a right-hand limit, a left-hand limit, and take advantage of these two ideas we just mapped out to solve this problem. So we'll start with the limit as x approaches 4 from the right-hand side, which is the same thing as x minus 4 times x plus 4 over x minus 4. So again, using this idea that the absolute value of x minus 4 is the same thing as just x minus 4, as long as x is something larger than 4, approaching 4 from the right-hand side. So x minus 4 over x minus 4 is just going to cancel out. So as x approaches 4 from the right-hand side, we only have to take the limit of x plus 4, which again is now a polynomial function. So we get 4 plus 4 equals 8 for that right-hand limit. Similarly, we can look at the left-hand limit as we approach 4 from the left-hand side. So this will become x minus 4 over x plus 4 over the opposite of x minus 4. So again, coming back to this line of reasoning we mapped out here. So x minus 4 over x minus 4 cancels out, but we still have this negative sign left over. So this becomes the limit as x approaches 4 from the left-hand side of the opposite of x plus 4. So we have a polynomial function, and again, direct substitution is going to tell us that this should be the opposite of 4 plus 4 or negative 8. So what we're interested in the limit as x approaches 4, looking at the right-hand limit, left-hand limit, we see that those are not equal to each other, which tells us the limit as x approaches 4 of x squared minus 16 over the absolute value of x minus 4. Again, in this case, does not exist. The one-sided limits are not equal to each other, so the limit does not exist.